I need your opinion of Red Engine versus CryEngine versus Frostbite.
CryEngine has such a sharp learning curve that a lot of people are driven to tears trying to learn it.
I thought it was because the graphics were so beautiful.
It makes beautiful landscapes, nature scenes, vines, trees, roads and so forth. But that's all the stuff the characters run past while playing the real game.
What about performance?
CryEngine uses a lot of resources on the user's system to generate the graphics, but it is not as hard on the developer's PC as some game development engines.
I'm more concerned about features that make game development easier than user experience at the end.
Frostbite makes a decent environment for users without sucking up system resources like CryEngine. And Frostbite does a good job of shading and lighting.
I thought Frostbite had better lighting.
It has better lighting fidelity, not creating weird shadows as a character moves through the artificial reality. CryEngine in general makes a more realistic virtual world though.
What about the way things move?
CryEngine wins when it comes to physics. It does not have just a single stock explosion for bullets or energy weapons.
Frostbite though, does a good job scaling up its explosions.
Bigger is not always better.
Sure, quantity matters too. How do they compare on price?
It is really hard to get a hold of Frostbite 3, unless you work for EA.
I do not know if that is a better deal than the 2014 rollout of CryEngine for $10 a month for their basic CryEngine version. What do you think of Red Engine?
Use Red Engine if you want to make role-playing games, especially those with non-linear stories. You can make both a big world and complex story, something many other RPG engines maybe pick between.
In short, you could have a big landscape, or complicated flowchart and AI dialogue database, but not both.
Red Engine does not have a lot of history or titles behind it, so there are not many resources for it.
The Witcher games certainly count.
Those are the only titles, if you do not count Cyberpunk 2077.
They are nice games.
Red Engine uses a flexible renderer, and a lot of blended landscapes that let you have a big, not quite blurry digital painting for the characters to move through. But if you want lifelike vines to swing on, go with CryEngine.
CryEngine does not have a lot of add-ons, and sparse sound files in the basic package.
Use Red Engine to make the next Dungeons & Dragons. Use CryEngine for anything else if you can figure everything out, and consider Frostbite the backup.